Fine. I'll come back. Just for this one time though, as I said, you won't see me around often and I'll only pop around every once in a while to break the dry spell, so stop crying about it in the comments please and thank you. Gee, it's almost like you're the overly attached child and I'm the dad. Actually, that's exactly what it is. Anyways, where do we start from here? This is some footage of some dope modded gameplay me and my buddy Tyler played on stream a while back, and unlike in the previous stream gameplay videos, I'm not gonna be using the live commentary from the stream because as I said earlier, I'm still in that phase where I don't want to shift things too drastically to avoid alienating the longtime viewers so much, so I'll choose these intense games to crack a cold beer, sit back, crack some jokes and whatever other shit people have came here for in over the 4+ years I've been around. So yeah. It's been forever since I've made any modding videos, and if you're a fan of those I'm sure you'll love these two. Unfortunately it's not something I plan to continuously make videos of cause they can only be fun to do for so long. Anyways, this is a mod I've actually played before in the past and made a few videos for. To be more specific, it's the Extra Cards mod made by David the Superior and some other people who I forget the name to, and I forget these names because I only ever associate this cards mod to David since he just loves to advocate the greatness of this mod all the time, lol. With that said, he's not wrong, this is one dank mod if you've never seen it before. And let me highlight the great features it has. Starting off small and getting into the bigger things. First, there's actually quite a few new maps they've incorporated into this mod, so instead of having to play the same old usual maps that I always play on normal classic mode, I can get a chance to experience a nice breath of fresh air. Granted, you won't really see a lot of that in this video, but it includes maps like the Labyrinth map I created a few months ago, the Forbidden Portal, which is a Jambite-made map, and the BTD5 maps like 3 times around. It also includes maps from Flash which are different from the ones on mobile, as well as maps that were changed on mobile in the past, like Interchange for example. You may not have noticed until now when I'm pointing it out, but yes, take a close look at the current map Tyler and I are playing on, and you will be able to tell something is off. Whether it be the textures or the balloon paths, all you need to know is this Interchange map is really really old Interchange. Back to the time when there used to be 3 lanes in the road was thicker and all the balloons came from the same direction. Now it's been shortened to 2 lanes and the player sent enters from the opposite path, but yeah. It's cool playing different maps for a change, that's all I have to say. Aside from just maps, there also exists an interesting game mode. One might even say it's nightmarish, and that's exactly what it is. And I'll explain what that game mode does when we get to that point. For now we are just playing classic card battles where both of us choose our 15 cards for our deck. But these aren't just ordinary cards. Well, some of them are, but a vast majority of them are custom made to wreak as much havoc as possible, whether it be a balloon sent that doesn't exist in current battles to something like a 4-4 tower. Like take a look at this for example. This laser cannon I have on my side, or at least it looks to be a laser cannon. But guess what, it's not actually a laser cannon, it's a Hydra Rocket's laser cannon, where the laser explodes upon contact with any balloon. And right by its side taking the entire spotlight is its superior counterpart, the 4-4 Dartling Gun, aka the Boz Laser Cannon Ray of Doom. It's a pretty good tower needless to say, that's probably why I brought it along with me. Go figure. Actually not really, I mostly kind of wing this deck loadout so I just made a quick judgment call and went home. This 4-4 tower for 35,000 bucks, sounds like a deal to me so why the hell not try it out. In hindsight I definitely would have brought a bunch of other cards along with me to make my life easier. For example the 4-2 factories which Tyler has over there. The reason for that is simple, more money, and who doesn't like money, a lot of money is what you need in order to send the beefiest of rushes in this mod. And that brings us to the next topic at hand, these filthy rush cards. If you ever stopped during your shower to think about what would happen if, say, Moabs, BFBs, or ZOMGs were allowed to regrow, then you wouldn't need to think about it anymore. You can see it live in action with the Extra Cards mod. Trust me, it's as scary as you think, especially when you think about BFBs regrowing back into ZOMGs. In particular though, there's this one card that is absolutely bonkers. I'm talking about a card that for a small loan of $1 million will send out 1,000, yes, 1,000 combo regrow BFBs, and 1,000 densely clumped ones at that. This is not a joke. I actually made a video about this 5 months back, but it's probably buried well beneath the pile of videos I made since then, so you may not recall what happened, but I'll briefly sum it up for you. I got fire trucked in the ace. Will the same happen again? Who knows, but as near impossible as these bloons sound to defend, there's at least three cards that can come to the rescue, two of which you've already seen used in action in this game. So think about this. What's the easiest way to counter a regrow bloon that you know you can't kill in time before it regrows back again? Simple, get rid of its combo status. And yes, the Purge Power card allows you to do just that, along with this unreleased card called the Cleansing Bomb, which just shoots out white foam all over the track just like the Engineer, which should cover most of the bloons. I say unreleased because I believe this card was shown in the Ninja Kiwi game files, but they never actually released it to the public, so you can't use it in battles if you were playing legitimately. But yeah, the counter to those nasty combo regrow blimps is by purging, or by spraying white foam at them. The third method is to use a Bloon Trap Engineer, which will slowly pump out that white foam by default. And there's a theoretical fourth counter using white foam, and that's my own self. However, I can't seem to find a way to get this white foam into the game. When I try, it just splatters on my laptop screen, and I have to spend a good 10 minutes cleaning it up. Forgive me for the terrible joke. Anyways, looks like things are about to go down, because yes, Tyler's now got the money to send me this ridiculous BFB rush. Like, even with purging, I don't think I have a chance against this shit. That's just way too much popping power required to take them all down at once. You'll need something like 5 dozen ground zeros and tech terror abilities at once to handle them all, but I don't got that. Those Ray of Dooms are the best I've got. But just as I'm about to take a fat L, look over on the other side, because Tyler's in for a world of trouble against the AI bloons as well. It's a goddamn photo finish, but at the end I barely scrape away the win as I was half a second from death. You can't get any closer to death than that. Well, actually you could if you were less than half a second from death, but you know what I mean. That was nuts. Definitely a must see if you miss this game on stream, cause I know a hell of a lot of viewers never get a chance to make it to a stream, whether it be because of time zones, having a life or something else. I don't blame you. That's what these stream highlight videos are for, and even if you saw them live, it can sometimes be cool to relive the moment, with added post commentary on top for maximum freshness you can only achieve with Ziploc airtight bags. This video is not sponsored by Ziploc, by the way. Okay, cool, on to the next time, and this is the nightmare game mode I was telling you about earlier. To break it down, it's a random cards game mode where Tyler and I are dealt identical hands of 15 cards each out of the 235 existing cards, although there's this bug where sometimes we're dealt different hands, which luckily did not happen this game. And as for what nightmare mode constitutes, well, first, that involves you not being able to sell any of your towers. So once you place it down, it's down for good. Unless your opponent kidnaps it or you sacrifice it for a temple. Also, towers get a nice price hike of 10% every round, so tower costs can get out of control really quickly, and I mean really. That 45k Ray of Doom tower I raved about so much would cost close to 200k if you were to get it later on, but the good thing is that I think Bannon's A Plus play with fire is enabled here, which does make things a lot simpler. Oh yeah. And mega boosts, we got 6 of each and with no cooldown, so we can spice things up a lot there. Either way, crazy ass game mode. I'm also speeding up the footage on this second game a bit because we are running out of time. I would like to keep the overall character count of this video below 10,000. Thank you very much. So, Vortex Storm. Our 15-deck loadout doesn't give us very many strong late-game bloons and options, and by that I specifically mean no combo regrow BFB or ZOMG rushes, but that doesn't matter when you got copers. Now bloon adjustment is really interesting here, because now that blimps can attain that comma slash regrow status, this can also affect the AI bloons and the cobra adjustment does just that, beefing up the AI blimps to the point where you have to take them down really quickly or else they're going to multiply into oblivion. And even worse is that neither of us have that purge or cleansing bomb card, only the bloon trap in which the white foam doesn't do much because you're gonna need a lot more of it as far as I'm concerned. And that's going to set me up for trouble because look here, I goofed up and let a couple of these bloon adjusted guys go a little too far, and at that point there's no turning back. I just have to watch as these guys march on by. Feels bad. Well, hope you enjoyed the gameplay or the OG commentary if you were only here for that. Again, I'll be around maybe every couple weeks or so. You should be able to tell where I show up if it's something like a mod or a potential sarcasm detector required video. Have a mayday.